Hello, Victor Nygren here. We are playing Total War 1942, a mod for Rome Total War, Barbarian Invasion. It works with both the original game and with Barbarian Invasion, but not Alexander. It has unique features from the Barbarian Invasion that were sadly removed from Alexander. That's why they didn't use Alexander. Unfortunately, this means no custom heroes. Hitler, Franklin D. Roosevelt, Stalin, etc. They are not heroes in or general unique custom generals or such in the game. They are just ordinary generals with a portrait, and some of them won't even have their own portraits because it's very hard to apply the correct portraits to them. Some of them have that because if you place them in the correct order, you can at least have two or three. Or something like that, leaders have their correct portraits. But this also means that that when adoptive family members spawn, or you get a general after winning a battle, that they can sometimes they will get the same portraits as the leaders. So in practice, this means that you can get generals in the campaign that will have Hitler's or Stalin's portraits. But you can also decline to recruit those generals, say no to them. But this also means that there are no custom models for leaders in this game, and they are just names and portraits. All right, we are going to play as Germany. The factions in this game are the British Commonwealth of Nations. They have the entirety of the empire. They are also known as the British Empire, of course. Dagovax chose to go with the British Commonwealth of Nations. That was the British name of their country during that time. Some of them said the British Empire and some of them said the British Commonwealth of Nations. Commonwealth is more peaceful, like if they had a commonwealth between themselves. Australia, New Zealand and Canada, but the British Empire is more correct because they also had India and South Africa and areas in the on the ocean, like different isles. They had lots of areas that didn't want to be a part of the British Commonwealth, and also unlike the Australians and the Canadians, for example, and New Zealanders, the Indians and the Africans, etc., they didn't have as many rights, so that's why they didn't want to be part of the British Empire, while the Canadians and the Australians and the New Zealanders, they had no problem with being a part of it because they enjoyed more rights, as I believe the Commonwealth were the English-speaking areas, and then the empire included, you know, India, Africa, etc. So, but Commonwealth sounds more good than empire, so I believe that's why he chose British Commonwealth of Nations as the name. All right, we have the French Republic, also known as the Free French. It's the loyalists of the free of the French Republic after the French Republic were defeated and surrendered to the Germans. We have the Spanish state that won the Civil War during 1936 to 1939, and they are led by Franco, who got help from Mussolini and Hitler to win the war against the Republicans and the communists in Spain. The Civil War ended in 1939, and he didn't want to be part of another war that soon after, so he stayed out of World War II. So he was neutral, but he did send lots of help to Germany and Italy by like peaceful means, like for example aiding them with money, weapons and such. He also sent an entire legion to Germany to be equipped with German uniforms and German gear, etc., and fight the Soviet Union. In the game they are allied, because if they are neutral they will be attacked immediately by Germany and others. That's how it works in Medieval 2 and in Rome Total War, that if you are a neutral country, you are open to be attacked. And if you are an enemy, you are also going to be attacked. But if you are allied, you are less likely. So that's why they are allied to Germany and the other Axis, even though they weren't in the real history. Alright, because allied in this game is the closest you get to, you know, being left alone. Alright, we have Turkey, a neutral country. We have the Japanese Empire. India, half of India is under British control, but the other half has like revolted. They want an independent India, and it's they are fighting the Japanese together with Britain, but they also want to get rid of the British. So sooner or later they are about to try and fight the British and reclaim their country. So you can say they will fight both the Allied and the Axis. Then we have the Soviet Union, also known as the USSR or United Soviet Socialist Republics. And then we have the Chinese Republic. It's not modern day China, it's the nationalist China. The government in Taiwan is the government that would have ruled this China, so it's pretty much Taiwan back when they ruled China. And they were also known as the Kuomintang. Then we have the People's Republic of China. They are the ones in control of modern day China. It's the communists in China. The nationalists were led by Chiang Kai-shek, and the communists by Mao Zedong. And then we have the French state Vichy. It's the French state that emerged after Germany defeated France in 1940. It's the Nazi French government. They even had the Nazi salute, but they didn't hail Hitler. They had another phrase. I believe they said something that meant "vi sverit." So they did the Nazi salute, and then they said "vi sverit" instead of cheering Hitler. We have the Third Reich, of course. The German Reich, Deutsches Reich is the German word for German Reich. So Hitler's Germany, the correct name for Hitler's Germany was simply German Reich. But there were two other German Reich before Hitler's Germany. So you can say the Holy Roman Empire during the Middle Ages were the first German Reich. And then you had the German Empire that emerged in the 1900s, and that were defeated during World War I. That was the Second Reich, and then Hitler's Germany is seen as the Third Reich. But in German it was known as Deutsches Reich, so the real name of the Third Reich is just German Reich. Alright, so then we have Bulgaria, an Axis power. We have Thailand, another Axis power. They were allied to Japan. They were kind of forced into an alliance. It was either joining Japan or being occupied by Japan, and they chose the first. Alright, and then we have the Italian Empire, led by Benito Mussolini. He actually wanted a new Rome. That was his war goal. If Mussolini had won the war, he would have created a new Rome, new Roman Empire, but his army weren't up to the task, so he didn't succeed in his mission. Then we have Hungary, another smaller Axis power. We have Finland and the democracy, but they are allied to the Germans and the other Axis, because or they are only allied to Germany, but indirectly allied to the others that are allied to Germany, because they have the common enemy of the Soviet Union. There were even Jews fighting in Finland's army, side by side with SS officers. I read an article about that. So in the Soviet Union there were Jews fighting side by side with Nazi officers against the communists of the USSR, because Finland was an ally, so the Nazi commanders couldn't do anything to the youth in Finland's army, because that would have been a hostile action against an ally. So they had to tolerate the Finnish army, even if it included youth. And the youth in the Finnish army had to tolerate SS officers fighting side by side, because Germans were allied to their country. You can say that the youth of Finland were Finns. They saw themselves as youth, but they also saw themselves as Finns. So they fought for Finland in the war, and Finland so happened to fight side by side with Germany, so it became a very odd situation for them. And then we had Romania, another small Axis power. They will betray Germany in the end, but in the beginning they were on their side. Then they changed government in like 1943 or something, and like joined the Soviets instead and attacked the Germans. All right, and we have neutral Portugal too. Also, we have the neutrals here because I used them when I play test. And then we have the United Nations, but they are edited out. All right, the third, the United Nations are also the Roman Senate. So we have the Third Reich here. The starting year is 1942. We won't read all the history. I will probably have to remove a lot of this text because I read something about the loading times being increased by 85% if you have more than a certain number of text or letters or whatever in the description. So I have a very long description here from Wikipedia, but I will probably remove most of the text to make the loading screen faster, because it's not good if it's becoming very long just because of some text. No one will probably read everything anyway. I did, but I like history, but most people won't probably even read it. So. Anyway, it has text from the start of the war, when the attack against Poland happens, and until when the army is in Stalingrad and Soviet is about to retaliate. Alright, let's start the game. It's an intro video here. It's kind of impressive with all these tanks moving in formation, like they are about to move against the Soviets, I believe. These tanks, by the way, we are fighting huge field battles, like similar to battles in the medieval era. They had huge battlefields with tanks, so it's very true to the Total War style. It's wrong that the perception that battles weren't fought like that during World War II. People seem to think that all battles during World War II were just a few guys moving around in companies, like in Call of Duty or Commandos or something. That's not true at all. It's true for the Western Front, because the Western Front were very civilized, with lots of buildings and roads and infrastructure and such. But the Eastern Front, like Ukraine and such, Belorussia, etc., the Eastern Front were very underdeveloped. I believe Russia itself were very industrialized, but they had huge spaces of like farmland and like areas where farmers lived, and in those areas there were very little modern infrastructure, and a lot of huge spaces for armies to fight, like tanks and artillery and infantry, etc. So we have the entire map visible here. There are a lot of changes done. I have a new unreleased version of the mod. So I have the German custom settlements in battle and on the map. I have modern roads. I have the trucks moving around on the roads. When I upgrade the roads, there will be trucks moving around instead of horse carriage. And then we have modern ships too, instead of fishing boats from the antiquity era. And I made it so that all the strat-map cities of the map are modern German cities, and the same with the battlefield settlements, because I didn't want any vanilla cities on the map. I've also added ships and made them work after I fixed an issue in the EDU or Export Desker Units file, where the ships, the strat model ships, had the same attack code as the battle model ships, and when looking at the vanilla ships, they had a different structure. So I changed all the ships, because previously, when I had the old ships in the EDU, when I clicked autoresolve, the game could lock itself up and I couldn't progress. I had to exit. That didn't happen all the time, but it happened sometimes. I believe in one play where I played for an hour or something, I had like four issues in a row where I couldn't click autoresolve in a ship battle without the game locking itself up. And I believe that happened also when the AI were using ships randomly. So not every ship battle did cost a game lock, but a lot of them did. And when the AI used the ships, the game could also lock itself up. So by fixing that, the ships can now fight without problem. And I've added ships to all the main factions, all the minor factions, including Spain, which is a great power, but we're neutral during the war, and therefore is weaker than the other great powers. It has no great fleet. It probably did historically, but the thing is that Dagovax only added good ships to the main factions of the war, like Germany, the United States, Japan, Britain, Vichy France, the Republic of the French Republic, and Italy, and the Soviet Union. So those factions have good ships, but everyone else only have transports, and they are good enough if you want to move troops to one area, from one area to another, but not good when facing battleships and stuff. All right, the AI in Rome is better than the AI in Medieval 2, so especially when it comes to using ships, so they will move ship around and boat blockade like in Medieval 2, but they will also move troops around a lot more. Actually, if you look at the army in Leningrad, you can see that they have quite a force, but their ships aren't that good. Soviet had a weak navy, but were mostly an auxiliary navy. In other words, it was more of a support to the land troops. It wasn't their main focus. They were more for land army with the navy as a support. So all the factions of the game have troopers, ships with these stats. We can see attack 8, 1 charge bonus, and 32 defense. 32 in defense isn't that bad. I mean, there are battleships with like 35 or 42 in defense. Then there are those with 75, 85, or 65. So it's not that bad, but it's still the worst. And as for attack, it's very bad with just 8 in attack and 1 in charge bonus, 9 in total attack. That's very bad, because the battleships, for example, have like 65 or something. So yeah, or 42, depending on the battleship. We have Germany's fleet here, it's stronger. So in the Baltic Sea, Germany has the upper hand. And the only threat is the Soviet fleet, because Finland is an ally and they don't seem to have a port. Also, Sweden isn't in the game, and Germany has already taken Norway and Denmark. We have the ports of Norway and Denmark too. I believe the port here is the one. Norway's port is here. I'm not sure if this is Finland's port, maybe. Neutral's port. No, it's a port. It is Sweden's port, but they aren't a country. They had a port. Very odd. They are neutral. Alright. Port without a city is kind of odd. Alright, but. The navies outside of this area can't reach the inner area of the Baltic Sea because these ports are in the way. They need to take either Copenhagen or I believe it's Hamburg. They need to take, but if Hamburg is connected to this port, and Stettin is connected to this, I'm not really sure what area is connected to these ports. Let's take a look here. One of the ports is Sweden's port, but there is no city to attack there. So I believe it's just for show. It does blockade this area, so you can't. Armies can't move this way there. At least not enemy armies. Other area. Very hard to move the mouse over it. It's owned by Denmark, I believe. It must be connected to Copenhagen, this one. Yeah. So if they take Copenhagen, they get control over that port. And as long as Jørgen has those ports, no one can enter the Baltic Sea. So the only threat we have here is the Soviet fleet, which is weaker. Because they have Sakya troops. We also have the best fleet here. If you look at our fleet in the Prussian port, the Riga port, then we see we have troopers, we have Hermelines, lots of Hermelines, and we have Prince Eugen battleships. They are generic for battleships. They are pretty good. If you look at the Hermelines, they have 24. 1 and 27 defense, so they have less defense than the transports at 32. They have way better attack at 24, one, so 25 in total. Then we have Prince Eugen battleship, they have 57 attack and 1 in charge bonus, so 58 in total. Way better than the Hermelines as well, and 42 in defense. Then we look at the best fleet, the Bismarck fleet. They have lots of Hermelines, they have a lot of Prince Eugens too, and the Bismarcks. In history they only had one Bismarck, one Eugen, etc. But the thing is, we have limited numbers of ships here, so instead of having like aircraft carriers, we have many Bismarcks. So yeah, I see these ships not as the Bismarck necessarily, but as battleships. So you can say they are used as generic ships. So the Bismarck is a generic battleship. Prince Eugen is a generic battleship as well, but a worse battleship. If you compare them, the Bismarck has 65 in total defense, and the Eugen has 42. And the Bismarck has 56 in attack and 1 in a charge bonus. It's a pretty strong fleet, but then we look at the British here. See that they have 3 fleets, one sucky fleet with their own troopers. And Black Swan ships, their Hermelines. Then they have a middle fleet here with also lots of Black Swan ships. And some good ships like the Hood here, similar to our Bismarck. And then they have their real fleet here with lots of Hoods, and even, I believe there's another one, Prince of Wales. I think the Hood is the better one too, but I'm not sure. Alright, attacking them would be suicidal. Just one fleet. I will move my fleet back to the port. Netherlands there. Alright, so the Brits have three huge fleets here. Yeah, in total we also have three fleets. We have a third one in the port of Tunis here in Africa with U-boats. They are similar to the Hermelin, 22 in the total defense and 22 attack and 1 charge point, so 23 in total attack. The difference is they can hide anywhere, so they are very good in that sense. They can hide and won't be seen. They can ambush other fleets. All the other fleets are visible because they are big things in the water, but the U-boats, they are kind of invisible. Of course, the Allied powers had submarines, their versions of U-boats, but there are no submarines in the game. So Germany is the only one with this type of trip, making them a threat to everyone else. We can also see that the United States had a smaller force here of ships, two ships. They used to land an army in Casablanca here in Africa. Then we have other fleets as well here. The Italians have a very strong fleet. They have the strongest fleet in the European theater. They have three huge fleets. This one is the strongest one at Palermo, led by Admiral Giovanni. The names are not correct because I didn't bother adding historical names to the files. I used the names that were already there. I choose Giovanni because the one of the true admiral weren't in the files. Alright, as you can see, they have battleships. They have the Giulio Cesare, and they have the Roma. Really good battleships, huge fleet. So Italy, while being kind of weak in the on land, is very strong in the water. Alright, they have another fleet here in the port of Rome itself. Not as strong, but still good. And then they have a third fleet in the port here of Tripoli. So they have three great fleets, making them a real threat in the Mediterranean Sea. We have Vichy France, the French government, and they still have a fleet in early 1942. They blew up most of their ships in November of 1942 because the Germans were planning on seizing them to use them against the Allies, and the French, while being on the German side because of the surrender in 1940, they still didn't like the Germans. And they didn't want the Germans to win the war. So they were in secret, they wanted the Germans to lose the war, and because of that they blew up the fleet before Hitler could get his hands on it. Now that isn't a problem in the game because there is no way to steal another faction's fleet. So by having the fleet in 1940, in early 1940, because the game starts in like January of 1942. By having the fleet, they will be a real threat at sea. This fleet is just the strongest fleet of Palermo here, but Italy has two other fleets too, so the French are not as strong. They are still a threat. I would still say they are a great power. When it comes to their navy, they are a great naval power, but they are a weak land power. They don't have much of an army on land. They have some areas in Africa, of course, like a few areas, and they have an isle here as well, but they are weak compared to the other main powers in the game. They aren't a main power. I would say they are the remnants of a great power, so they are more like a minor power. I believe they have 10 regions or something. Can be compared with Germany's 28 regions and Britain's 30 regions, or United States maybe 18, 20 or something regions. They have a lot of isles to see through too. Alright, Spain has been increased. They have a new region here, Sevilla. Previously in version 1.3 they had only Barcelona and Madrid, but now they have another area, Sevilla here, and they have an area in Africa, El Ayun. Alright, so you have seen the fleets here. You have the German U-boat fleet together with the other two fleets. German has three fleets just like Britain and Italy, but as the German fleet is separated, their fleet isn't as strong as the United British fleet here and the Italian fleet here. The French only have one fleet, so they are weaker but still stronger than the smaller factions. Soviet Union has another fleet here in the Black Sea port of Sevastopol, and they have their weak, I believe they have their stronger fleet here actually, with some battleships, not many but some. So yeah, they have two fleets, one that is weaker than our fleet and then another one that is stronger that will dominate this sea here. They can't move out without defeating the Turks here, they are blocking their way. So they will terrorize Romania and Turkey in these waters, but can't really move out of there until they have taken Istanbul. Alright. And there is a way to move down here as well for navies. So they can provide support to areas down here. So that's the fleets in the European theater. Then we have the Pacific theater, or the Eastern theater. We have the American Navy in this port here. They only have two ships. Historically there were two aircraft carriers out at sea when the attack on Pearl Harbor happened, when the Japanese fleet attacked Pearl Harbor and sank most of the American fleet. They had two aircraft carriers out at sea, and here they have anchored at this port here. But they are not aircraft carriers. I've added battleships instead because there are no aircraft carriers in the mod currently. So battleships are kind of their replacement. We have British, the British Eastern Fleet here. The British East Pacific Fleet. Their worst fleet out of two that they have in the Pacific. So one fleet is there, and then they have one in Singapore as well, their main East Pacific fleet under Admiral Archer here. We have fleets of the Japanese Empire, really strong fleet there, and a weaker one here. And then we have their strongest fleet at Manila. So they have three fleets, meaning the Japanese are the strongest in these waters. But the British, with their two great fleets, are almost as strong. Had the American fleet not been sank, they would have had 3-2. So you can say Japan has the upper hand at sea, but Britain isn't far behind. And if Britain were to combine those fleets with their European fleet, they would be the stronger faction at sea. But that, but the fleet in Europe will have to deal with Italy's fleet and Vichy France and Germany's. They are kind of busy in both seas, while the American fleet sadly doesn't have a lot of ships anymore. They have enough to move troops around but not enough to face the Japanese. Alright, I've also added Alberta and the city of Calgary to the United States. It was owned by the British Empire previously, because I believe Legovax and Leonid thought that it was part of Canada, but it wasn't, because what should I say, Alaska, this region, were used to be owned by the Soviet Union, and the United States bought it from the Soviet Union, so it should be with the United States. I've added loyalty to the region for the United States. I replaced the British loyalty with United States loyalty in the region's file. So now, if revolts happen after someone else takes the city, then they will revolt to the United States or the rebels. And I've added the area to the United States, and I've replaced the British garrison with American units. So now it's correct in the sense that the region belongs to America and not Canada. So Canada only has these areas here, while America owns the whole of Alaska. Meaning they have a border here too, and may actually try to go to the Soviet Union. That would be interesting. I've never played a version with this change before. I've also played a lot of campaigns where I were the rebels and just saw how the AI would do, and these armies here couldn't move. So in the end, the Germans would steamroll Soviet. I believe I have removed the immobile trait from these armies, so they will actually move now and be a threat to Germany and others. That will be interesting when they combine their armies and go on the offensive. They might actually steamroll Finland and take the Italian areas and Hungarians and other stuff here. Soviet will not be that easy now, and they actually will go to on the offensive with all their troops. Otherwise they would just stand here and send new armies to Germany that will be easier to handle, and in the end Germany would steamroll Soviet because they would have time to build up their modern forces and tech, and then they would take all the minor factions here and Italy and even Turkey, and then they would just steamroll Soviet and then go down to the Middle East and later into Africa. At the end of the campaign they would hold most of Africa. But by making Soviet more dangerous, by removing the immobile trait, they will now go on the offensive, so Germany might actually lose them. But we are not going to see how the AI will do as Germany this time, because we are playing as Germany, so it will be us who will be fighting the Soviets if they go on the offensive. Alright, let's remove the toggle FOV. So no visible map anymore. We have the fog of war on. It's more fun to play with the fog of war on. Map is huge. You can hardly see your own regions, but now I can see them if I zoom in like this. So you'll do that. All right. The Soviets will go on the offensive. I believe. We can move troops to the cities, but I will move out the mechanized units here. Try to create a mech-only army. That was almost a full army. Infantry is good to be used in actual defense. So which general is the best? That general wasn't that good. We have Heinz Guderian here. Both are similarly bad because I removed the triggers for traits. I believe that's why. Alright. We will add unit here. I believe we will add snipers to the army. Need one infantry unit to handle rams, etc. Alright. I don't believe we will move this time. If we move to that spot, they might actually have an army in ambush there that will attack us. Another army here under. We have another army here under General von Klug. or Gunther von Klugenmund. Alright. Let's move these mechanized units out. And the better troops. We will leave 4 riflemen there at least to defend. They will probably take back Smolensk. Maybe I should move this army back. Yeah, I think I wanna do a heavy assault on these border regions. Yeah. They will counterattack with a heavy force there. Alright. Also, I don't trust my allies, so I will need to move troops to their borders to defend. Because if we are weak on the borders, then they will betray us and attack us. So we will need armies on the borders with Hungary, Bulgaria, and Italy as well, and Romania. So, but the main threat is, of course, the Soviet Union here. So, I believe we can take a look at the faction overviews. So the capital city is Berlin, faction leaders Adolf Hitler, family members are 16, regions controlled, we have 27 regions, battles won 0, battles lost 0, victory conditions, survivor, hold 15 provinces and destroy or outlast the following faction or factions: United States of America, French Republic, United Soviet Socialist Republics, British Commonwealth of Nations. So we need to hold 15 regions to win. And those factions need to be destroyed. Doesn't matter if we are the ones destroying them, but they need to be destroyed, and we need to hold 15 regions when they are in order to win. We will put automatic taxes on, and we will place this in the middle. We look on the family tree, we only have Adolf Hitler himself and Eva Braun. And Eva Braun is now 30, that's correct, I believe. Hitler is 40, that's about correct, I believe. And then I believe he was older, maybe he should be like 48 or something, but it's around those years. Anyway, we have the faction ranking here. You can look at the overall ranking, military ranking, production ranking, territorial ranking, financial ranking, population ranking. Yeah, and own faction, all factions, living factions, top 5 factions. So Germany, the United States of America, the Soviet Union, the British Empire, and the Japanese Empire, they are the 5 strongest factions in the game. Italy didn't make it, but they are also a main power. Spain is supposed to be a main power, but they weren't a part in the war, so they are weaker too. Italy isn't weaker, they just sacked, so that's why they didn't get a lot of regions too, because they would be much stronger than they were historically. Anyway, we can't see any statistics the first turn, we need to play a few turns in order to get some statistics. After the first turn you can see statistics, but not before that. You can look at the overviews here, we have military forces like Erwin Rommel, Adolf Hitler, Heinz Guderian, Erich von Manstein, Gerd von Rundstedt, Gunther von Klug, George von Kutchler, Gunther Alterbung, and some admirals that are not historically accurate. If it were correct, it would be like Admiral Dönitz or something. Yeah. The portraits are not correct for Rommel and other generals. For example, Erich von Manstein has the portrait of, I believe, I believe it's, yeah, isn't Manstein, I believe he must be one of the others. Anyway, agents, we don't have any agents currently. If you look at the financial situation, it looks good for now, but I believe we will go minus when we click next turn. We have a lot of areas and armies. And then diplomacy, we can see that we are allied to Japan, French state, Vichy, Bulgaria, Italian Empire, Hungary, Finland, and Romania. Also the Spanish state as a bonus to prevent them from being at war with us immediately. And then we have the enemies, the British Commonwealth, the United States, the French Republic, and the Soviet Union. Then we can see the other factions, they also have some allies and enemies. Neutral factions like Turkey and Portugal doesn't have any allies or enemies. India only has Britain and the US as, and the USA as allies. They have no enemies in the start of the game. People's Republic of China has Japan as an enemy, but no one else. And are not allied to anyone. Alright. So, let's build some stuff. Let's look at the buildings first. I think it would be correct to have good roads from the start, actually. We will do this. I don't remember the code. Anyway, we will build roads. That's what we will build at first. In real history, they already had the autobahn when they started the war in 1939. So I thought maybe I should use the cheat code to build all the roads immediately, but I don't remember the code. Now I kinda do. Alright, we will try that, because I think they should have the roads from the start, actually. Process CQ. Berlin. And we can build asphalt roads. Good. That's the best roads. We have asphalt roads from Berlin now. But that's not enough. We need good roads everywhere. I'm gonna play without cheats, but I will make an exception for the roads, because they were supposed to be built by this time. So some areas doesn't have any roads buildable. We have Tunis there. I don't believe Tunis had one. It's in Africa. München, yeah. All the German areas should have that. All the European German areas. Hamburg, of course. This road, by the way, is a cobblestone road. It's the one before asphalt. So Hamburg. Alright. Cobblestone Road. Frankfurt. They had the possibility to build asphalt roads too. So we will build roads everywhere where we can build roads. Amsterdam as well. Bristol, alright. Make things more correct by building this from the start. So Paris, of course, should have such roads as well. France weren't behind in that regard. Also, I believe the farms here are vanilla, so we could build those as well. I don't see why not. So we have built what we could there. I don't particularly care about vanilla stuff. It's a remnant. I'm not convinced they had good roads there, but they certainly had farms. So our money is about to run dry there. Kiev. I'm not sure if they had modern roads in Kiev. Minsk, etc. I don't know. Here we have a very old road. Dirt roads in Heracleion. I don't know, but I think in Greece they were kind of modern. We will upgrade to dirt roads there. We have Riga, of course, they are modern. It's close to Scandinavia. As you can see, there are trucks moving on the road. And now we have no money to build anything more for now, so no troop recruitment this time. So we built cobblestone roads and asphalt roads and some farms, stuff that they should already have. We didn't build roads in areas in the Soviet Union because they had very underdeveloped roads, etc. That's why the tanks got stuck in mire and stuff, because they didn't have modern roads there. So the underdeveloped roads, etc., helped the Soviet Union in the war, while the Germany's developed roads were bad for Germany in the end, because they allowed the Soviets to just move straight to Berlin in a very fast speed. So we have cobblestone roads and asphalt roads here. Not all the areas were updated. Prague, for example. We still have money, so we can. We have 200. And there are still roads that can be built, but we don't have money for the roads yet. We have money, so we can build some troops to or recruit some agents and troops. Cement recruit, not build. Anyway, we only have 200. I guess we will build some BMW motorcycles then. As you can see, we have BMW motorcycles here. Rifleman, the militia unit of the game. The most basic troop. We have assault infantry with machine guns instead of ordinary rifles. We have scout snipers that lay down when they fire. They can fire from a very long distance. We have the BMW motorcycles with machine guns. We have Panzer I, the small shell that they fire. They can also drive over infantry units. We have Panzer IV. They have the medium shell. We have the anti-aircraft truck, a new unit. We have the Stuka strategic bombers. We have the Pack 40 artillery. We have the Vesp mobile artillery. We have the Stokes mortar artillery. We have the Messerschmitt 109 fighter plane. And we have spies, female spies. We have assassins based on American cowboys for every faction with different skins. Spies also have different skins, and we have a diplomat. Alright. We are going to recruit diplomats, but we didn't have the money for it now. Alright. Now it's just about time to move the troops where we can. So, Soviet is going to invade, most likely. We will move back for now. Let's move out one unit there. Move this army too. Alright. Smolensk will probably be taken. We have a huge army in Kyiv and another one in Minsk. In Riga we should have some troops too. I'm expecting to be invaded on many fronts. Could move troops from Warsaw closer to the border with Italy. They don't get any ideas about invading us. So we have some troops here. I need to move these troops out and merge them with other troops. Also, this mod has total diplomacy, so you can force allies and enemies to do what you want, but it's cheating if you do it against enemies. But you can do it against allies to keep them in line. That's why we implemented that feature. So we added some troops from Belgrade to the army there. Now we need to add some troops from Zagreb as well. Good. We need 4 riflemen to defend. And we will move these forces to Vienna. Seems they could move all the way to Zagreb. But I believe we need them in Vienna to defend against the Italians. They could always assist the area of Zagreb if it is attacked later. We will also move these troops to Prague. The mechanized units could move all the way to Vienna, so we will do that. Probably thanks to some roads there. The roads will increase the trade, but they will also make it possible to move troops more effectively and longer distances. So that's why we will use the sheet to build the roads as soon as possible in Germany, because they had all the roads already built in 1939. So there are no troops in Berlin, and we can't move the leader. Because he stays in Berlin until it is taken. He will die with Berlin, if you will, like in history. And then had some troops here that could move. We move them towards Vienna as well. So we have troops in Hamburg. And move them to München. They are neither at the border with which you French. So France doesn't betray me. Amsterdam has some troops too. Move them to München, the mechanized troops. And one of the SS soldiers could move as well. In Bristol, I believe we have to keep some stuff. We can move one unit to... No, that wasn't good. Move him back. Still blue. Alright. Seems we can't move any more troops there. We won't attack any of our allies. They will have to attack us first. As for Soviet Union, I want them to attack first. And the reason is because they have a lot of troops there. We have already invaded them and taken areas. I mean, look at the map. We took Poland first. So our armies marched into Warsaw and took Poland. Prior to that, we had done the Anschluss with Austria here, Vienna, and also taken like the Czechoslovakian area here, Zagreb, or the the Yugoslav capital of Belgrade. And then we helped Italy with the invasion of Greece. Then we divided Greece between ourselves and Italy and Bulgaria. So Bulgaria has its own area, Sofia here, and they have Saloniki here. I don't know if it's a Bulgarian area or if it's a Greece area, probably a Bulgarian one. But in history they helped in dividing Greece. We are holding Athens, the capital of Greece, while Tirana is held by the Italians. You can say they have divided Greece between them. And after that we took Copenhagen, the Danish capital, and we took Oslo, the Norwegian capital. Then we have taken the Netherlands capital of Amsterdam and the Belgian capital of Brussels, and after that the French capital of Paris, and taken additional areas in Paris, such as Bordeaux and Rouen. But we let the Vichy French have Lyon and Marseille, alright. Then we went to the east, before we went to the Eastern Front, we took Crete here, Heracleion, and we have entered Africa and taken Benghazi and Tunis. We have Rommel here with an army. He will move back to Benghazi. Then we have another army in Tunis as well. And then we move east and took Brest, liberated Riga from the Soviet Union, took Minsk, the capital of Belarus, and Kyiv, the capital of Ukraine. Then we moved on and took Stalino. It's not Stalingrad. Stalingrad is here somewhere. we took Stalinov and then we have taken Smolensk here, but we still haven't taken Leningrad. Our fleet is now blockading their port at Leningrad, and our second fleet here has entered this port. Can't move more at this time. We have the U-boat fleet here that I want to send out to fight the British or others. They were terrorizing the Atlantic, so we're going to send them to the Atlantic. Alright, they can't be seen. We will be able to ambush other fleets. And that's it for this turn, I believe. We will click next turn. So the Soviets did indeed attack. They attacked with their fleet. I believe I have solved the issue with gamelock when I click autoresolve, but I'm not 100% sure. So we will save the game before clicking autoresolve. So you can see they have a large fleet just like we have. We have battleships like Prince Eugen here, and lots of Hermelines and troopers. They have troopers as many as us, and they have their version of the Hermeline, the Orlen. So they are equal in that sense, but they have only Orlens. They have no battleships here. That's why they will lose that battle. Let's save the game, so I don't have to replay stuff. Autoresolve, clear victory! Yes, it worked. Admiral Friedrich of the German Reich had 20 ships deployed, lost 0, ships remaining 15. I meant they sank 0. Alright, and Admiral Luka of the Soviet Union had 20 ships, sank 5 of our ships. Ships remaining 20. That's odd. We won the battle, but they sank 5 of our ships, and we sank 0 of theirs. And still we won, but I don't get that. Alright, and here are the detailed statistics. And the Soviets are invading, as expected. See, we are on the map, we need to click here. They are attacking outside of Stalino. They have lots of armies now that can attack. So we have T-34 tanks with medium shells. They are there like equivalent of the Panzer IV. And then they have a General's bodyguard with just riflemen. Two units, they have 10 T-34s and 2 General's bodyguard. Alright. Riflemen bodyguards are worthless. So. Let's let the army under Heinz Guderian be controlled by the AI, and we will control this rifleman unit. Fight the battle on the battle map. Fight to the dash. Hello, Victor Nygren here. The game locked the prior when I tried to fight this battle, so we will try again. When loading a saved game, you always need to activate the script by clicking here, so I will do that now. So the script is active. And then we will jump right into the battle and hope it won't crash this time. We are attacked by the Soviet Union. I would say to the House, as I said to those who have joined this government, they have nothing to offer but blood, toil, tears and sweat. Winston Churchill, 13th May 1940. Right, we are in control of one regiment of riflemen. We will put it in loose formation and then start the game. It's probably a good idea to retreat towards the other army there. Or maybe not. Let's just suicide them. They were too close to the enemy here. We have 10 regiments of T-34 tanks and then 2 riflemen bodyguards. Yeah, they are already broken. That was expected. So what about the real force? Our panzers here. We are about to enter. Lots of T-34s here at the border too. Some T-34 reinforcements there. We have Panzer I's, planes, our U-88 bombers, Stuka strategic bombers. We even have fighter planes, the Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. Some Panzer I's here, moving around. Some BMW motorcycles, even a Tiger bodyguard. Probably the general, that one. Otherwise, we don't have tigers this early in the game. And I believe we have some Panzer IVs there as well. Panzer IVs, they are equal on equal level with the T-34s. Both are firing medium shells, while the Panzer I's are only firing small shells. The tigers are firing something else, much better. The reinforcements have arrived on both sides. And one of the generals had died. I believe the enemy general died. One of the two. The enemy generals died. They've already lost a lot of the tanks. The Soviet Union attacked us during the AI's turn. So we'll see how this will go. Heroic death, Captain Arthur. So one of the captains died. Probably my captain. The other army had a general, I believe. Come on, Panzer I's. I know they are at a disadvantage against the T-34s, but we had the numerical advantage in this battle, so we might still win, and we have the planes. I believe if we win, it's thanks to the planes. You can see the Tigers are firing some kind of barrel projectile instead. They actually do explode when they hit. They are better than the large shell. It's the best shell used by the tanks. And new for this version. Taken from the ships. The ships have different projectiles, but the difference between them is that some of them fire 2 shells at once, some of them 3 shells, and even 4 shells. And the tanks have the worst one that only fires 1 shell. But that's still good for a tank. Look at this, it will take out a tank in one hit. Continue the battle. They don't regroup and stuff. We need them to at least have lost 85%. I believe that's the number. To prevent them from, you know, surviving the battle, or at least being a threat after the battle. They are at 80% now. We need more of them killed. Let's take a look at our other troops here. Panzer Force moving. Panzer Ones, I believe we may have won. Enemy General fallen, P3, alright. P3 Ivanov and Sergei Ivanov died. Right, so Captain Arthur had 81 men and 12 remaining. Heinz Guderian had 489 men and killed 587, had 403 remaining. So they lost some of the tanks. Sergei Ivanov and Pyotr Ivanov, they had 361 men both. And they killed 108 and 52 respectively. So they killed way less than our army, and they have 66 left of both armies that managed to escape. And here is the detailed statistics screen. So we're done here. Just as the defending force has gathered valuable experience from deeper, so has the assaulting force. He will not do it like this a second time. Field Marshal von Rundstedt, August 1942. AI is still doing their stuff. We have man of the hour. Alright. End of turn report, we are minus 7,891. That's expected in the beginning of the game. Largest faction. Our faction's boundary is stretched to the far horizons, bringing German rule to many. No other faction can match the size of our lands. Yeah, I know. New family member, the Third Reich, Paul von Rundstedt. Alright. So we have 27 regions in total. The Soviet Union are besieging Stalino, held by infantry, I believe. Yeah. And the general Erich von Manstein with an infantry army of mostly riflemen, but also some Waffen-SS troops. Two Waffen-SS. And one sniper unit and two assault infantry. The Waffen-SS and the assault infantry have about the same stats. No, they used to have the same stats, but now the Waffen-SS have better stats than the assault infantry. They have better in everything because they are supposed to be an elite version of that unit, but they have the same gun. They used a better defense and better missile damage, and probably better attack as well. All right. So we have four riflemen there. We will face that Soviet army. Our arm here is too far away. Let's move that unit there. So we will fight that battle. Alright, we have an army here. Two units there as well. Lost a few units in the last battle. So I guess we will move back this army. Move back to Kiev. And move out all the mechanized units to the army here. Alright, now it's ready to attack. There are two infantry units in that army. I don't need riflemen in the army, so I will move the riflemen out. Then we will of course move the best infantry, the SS, into the army instead. Alright, that's a good army, and I guess Manstein will have to defend the next time we click next turn. Alright. This army could move back to Riga for now. We'll move out some troops from there, including the SS and the mechanized units. We leave 4 riflemen in Riga. Then we can move them towards Brest. Alright, there are some worthless units here. 4 units of riflemen. I don't need riflemen in the army. Let's move the Wesp there. It couldn't reach. We move the BMW motorcycles, the Panzer IVs, and the planes. The Messerschmitt 109s there instead. Now we have a fully mechanized army here. But with some additional snipers, SS, assault infantry, etc. I guess we can keep those, but because the artillery could be used in defense. We have 3 other, yeah, we could still get rid of the assault infantry. And move another panzer unit to the army. You don't need that many SS troops either. Infantry is bad even if they are elite. So we move the Messerschmitt 109 there instead. And that SS unit, we don't need it either. We move the BMW motorcycle. So that's better, an almost totally mechanized army. We need all the mechanized armies we can get because the Soviet Union can move their starting armies, and they have a lot of starting armies, so we will face a very huge force here coming from the east, and then we also have to face possible betrayals from our allies. So we really need good armies without infantry. We need at least 1 unit of infantry in every army because they are needed for certain settlements when we don't have artillery and when we need to use rams. Now we have some Wesps here, so we don't really need them, but it's always good to have at least 1. I would like to replace probably 1 of the infantry units with the SS unit with that Wesp unit, but we do that next time. So Brest has been emptied. They have no... We have no mechanized units in Bresk anymore. We have 2 generals here. I think that's a waste. We don't need 2 generals in a city. The other general can move to Minsk, the governor of Minsk instead, in case Kyiv will be besieged soon. So here we have another great force, the one that we're fighting. And we have 1 here ready to fight against another starting army. Let's see here in Warsaw, we have only infantry. Infantry is good at defending. So we will mostly defend with our infantry. Here we have some mechanized troops, but they are moving towards the front with Italy. In case Italy should get any ideas about betraying me. Move the mortar there too. Zagreb is weak currently. Same with the Belgrade, the capital of Yugoslavia. Occupy Yugoslavia. Alright, but we will move the SS infantry here to the army. And I believe this army could move back towards Athens. Can't leave Athens too weak. Alright. four infantry units there in Prague. Then in Stettin we have four additional infantry units. We have too few in Frankfurt. We can't move anything right now from Hamburg. Let's move an SS unit. Maybe not. Maybe it was needed there. Alright. So we move a rifleman unit back. Can't move anything from here. I know they are red, but... Alright, we were about to build roads in most cities. And I weren't done because I got... I didn't have any money left, so I couldn't fulfill it. I will use the console command process CK settlement because CK settlement because Germany is supposed to have the autobahn at the beginning of the war in 1939, so from all the German regions we will build the latest roads, but we won't use any money sheets. So we will build them using the fast build cheat, but we will still use the money we have from the start, so we can't build everything on the first or second turn. Alright, same with farms. I believe such things were already developed. So let's move the BMW motorcycle towards the front from Berlin. And take a look at construction. In Berlin we could use that farm. It's a vanilla building that has no place in this game anyway. So I'm just getting rid of remnant here. Remnant of vanilla Rome. So we have the latest version of the farms there. So we could Tunis doesn't need that right now. I don't believe they had roads there. In München they probably had farms. So we will actually build that. So Oslo, yeah, of course they had farms. Want to waste time building worthless buildings. It should already be available by this time. Hamburg had farms too. Almost out of money, so we will have to build the roads the next turn. Don't have money for that now, or troops. I believe it's good for preventing like revolts, etc. To have like farms and stuff from the start. At least that will give them food, which means they are less likely to be upset in the cities. So we have Britain here with huge fleets. We moved our fleet here. Right, and I'm attacking the Soviets here as well. We beat the Soviet fleet in the previous turn. I don't know if we can win against this fleet here. Let's move our fleet towards the port here. It's not ours, it's a Swedish port. Alright, let's move there instead. have built some farms. So we have Erwin Rommel here. I think we will leave 4 units there and move the rest. It's time to attack. Attack Tobruk, held by the Free French. The loyalists of the defeated French Republic. They have infantry here, then they have some dangerous units, the anti-aircraft trucks. And the Renault FT tanks. I believe the only real threat there is the anti-aircraft truck. Right, and here we have another force. Could be starting to move them as well. Smaller force. And we had the U-boat fleet here. So about to move out towards the Atlantic. United States fleet here. Can't sink it right now, but it's a weak fleet, so we will attack it if it's still there the next time. The U-boats were known for sinking American ships between America and Britain, etc. So of course they are going to sink them, especially now when we are at war with the United States. It's 1942, so... Alright, the British have 3 fleets in Europe and 2 of them are here, but I believe it's the weak fleet that we could beat quite easily with 1-4 ships, 1-4 fleets. And then the other one is the second weakest. They have some good stuff like the Hood. 5 Hoods, I believe, but otherwise they are kind of weak with only Black Swans, I believe. I don't know where they have their best fleet. Here, it seems to be. It has a lot of good stuff. So they have it outside of Rowan. Alright. We had some battles to fight here. Let's just attack. And we will save in case it CTDs or crash the desktop. This will be an easy win. They are much smaller than our army. Now let's start. Yes. Soldiers of the Reich, this day you are to take part in an offensive of such importance that the whole future of the war may depend on its outcome. Adolf Hitler, 5th July 1943. Probably before they were about to fight the Battle of Kursk, the great tank battle in Soviet Russia. Alright, start deployment. We are only a rifleman unit, alright. Loose formation, and it's best to probably retreat the army or the unit actually back towards the army. So this army is rowing up here on the battlefield. They have some Panzer IVs here. They have some lot of infantry. Assault infantry, SS, snipers, even riflemen. And of course the Jeep, the BMW motorcycles, yeah. Panzer I's. Messerschmitt 109s and Stukas are at the front towards the enemy here. About to move down on the enemy. The Soviet Union is outnumbered. They have 5 units of T-34 medium tanks and 1 unit of riflemen, that is the bodyguard of their... they have like 241 men in 1 unit, but it's better than other infantry units because they have a lot of people in the unit, but we have 81, they have like 241. Alright, but they still don't have one. So. So the fighter planes are firing their projectiles towards the enemy on the ground. In this mode, the planes are better than the tanks, especially since I did some alterations in the stats for the units to make planes better than tanks, because it was ridiculous when the tanks won against the planes. I don't particularly like mountainous terrain like this, because it looks so old when they fight on mountain terrain, but it will have to do in certain areas. Even though the tanks doesn't look that good when they move on mountains. Alright. Panzer 4 tanks. Coming to the aid of the planes here. And the Soviet tanks are already defeated. Don't they have anything more? They only have the infantry here in the back. They are probably trying to withdraw from the battlefield. I wouldn't be surprised. Alright. Our fighter planes are already firing at them. They have a very long range, so extremely long range actually. As you can see, they reach pretty far. Well, the bombers need to be closer to drop their bombs. But I believe the Stuka bombers have a wider range than the U-88s. The U-88s need to pretty much be above the enemies. Or almost. So 43 left. Over half their regiment has died. Alright. Continue the battle. So they don't survive. Ah, the Stukas have dropped some bombs there. And they are dead. And Mineral died there too. Alright, Nikolai Ivanov died. He only killed 3 of our troops, alright. That was a smaller battle. Hitler and Mussolini never could afford to withdraw their volunteers 10 times as many as we had, and it could no longer be denied that the British government was a silent partner in the fascist powers' attempts to strangle Spain, that we were witnessing one of the most amazing and cynical displays of hypocrisy in world history. Alva Betsy, Men in Battle, A Story of Americans in Spain, 1939. Alright. Can't move any more with that army, so we could move this unit in there for now. I would like to send something back to the city, but we can't move that far, I believe. That's unfortunate. I don't want to move the mechanized stuff. Let's move one of the generals there then. We moved Gunther von Klug. And what general is this? Hans Goebbels. It's a generic general. Well, the other was a historical general. We'll move him back later. Alright. We can't do anything more this turn, so we will click next turn, I believe. And the enemy will probably attack. Yeah, the Soviet Union have attacked Stalino. They want Stalino back from us. And Erich von Manstein is defending the city with a lot of infantry units, including 2 Waffen-SS elite infantry units, 1 sniper unit, and two assault infantry units, alright. And their army is just the ordinary 5 T-34s and 1 regiment of riflemen bodyguard. But we don't have any tanks this time, which means they may actually win, even though we have all of these infantry units. It will be interesting to see. So we are holding a I believe we have some kind of town. Alright, let's start the battle. I may not have played in this custom settlement before. If it's the village or town, I believe, then I have played it before. But if it's the large town or the city, then I haven't played it. I believe it's the large city. I mean the large town. I played a town. It looks like a village. But the actual large town, I haven't played in it, and it's pretty epic. So let's see here, because I watched a video with Diego explaining it. Yes, this is the large town. It's pretty cool. Start deployment. You can see the large town. We have this defensive position here. Outside, so a modern wall with modern machine gun towers here. They are in the released version too. Then we have the large town itself. Really impressive town. We even have cars. By the way, the cars are actually buildings, so they can be destroyed. We have the there are some glitches in the new settlements sometimes in the early game, because this building, for example, is a vanilla building. And it's still in the game. If we upgrade the building, this building will change. So as long as it's the older building, it will look like that. Alright. This is really impressive, this city. Large town. I mean, he has added different like buildings and made the roads different. They aren't vanilla like the large city. He made it easier for himself, like he kept the original paths, etc. But in this, he actually went the extra mile and did his own stuff, and I believe he did so too with the city. So the large city is a little more simple than the large town and the city. Alright, so we are defending. But the large city is still very impressive. Alright, loose formation, and we will place them on defense. And let the computer take over, I don't care. Alright, this could go bad for Manstein. So we have the snipers. They probably lay down on the ground soon. I wonder if they can fire through the wall too, I'm not sure. We have lots of infantry. We have even a jeep bodyguard. So Manstein has a jeep with machine gun. Machine gunners there. Our towers here are firing towards the enemy. If they get closer, they need to break the gate, and they have a jeep here to do that. I wish Degwex would add the drivers to these rams, because as part of the model, because it looks kind of odd when they have no guys inside of them driving them. Anyway, we'll see if they succeed or if the ram is destroyed. 56% destroyed already. I believe we can win this battle by destroying the ram. That's probably the only way we can win. Otherwise, their tanks will steamroll our troops. They almost... They immediately took down the gate with that ram truck. Now they will just steamroll the city. Here come their infantry, generals, bodyguard. And after them will the tanks. Oops, and the tanks are about to enter now. Time to defend, soldiers. What are you doing? Here, the first tank has arrived, the T-34s. Oh no, the second one. They've already reached this far into the city, or the large town. So my infantry battalions here, are they gonna be able to stop them? Idiots, can they not? They're supposed to attack. I forgot to click attack on them. Now my troops are moving finally. It may be too late. The jeeps can actually take down the planes, hopefully. But I've nerfed them, so they may not be strong enough for that now. They are just as strong as the BMW motorcycles. They are not stronger. So, unlike before, they might actually lose to the tanks. Which is more correct. Yeah, they aren't that strong. SS battalions running towards the plaza. With the rest of the infantry and the jeeps coming behind. Hurry up! You're losing! Fortunately, with this wall, the tanks have a hard time to enter. It's not impossible, but they will take their sweet time. Fuck that tank. It just threw over a lot of my infantry and made them broke. Or break, I meant. They made them broken. Alright, their tanks are at the center of the large town. And we are moving there. Soldiers! Run towards the plaza. Alright, there are some infantry trying to hold off the tanks here, getting driven over. Alright, didn't go well. Being fired at and driven over. Our tanks have gotten stuck, but we managed to stop their tanks from winning here. The SS infantry unit managed to reach the plaza in time. But they're now in a locked struggle with the tank. They have pistols in close combat, as we can see. So there's a mess of things here. Their troops haven't really entered yet. This wall is very good because they don't seem to be able to destroy the actual wall, and their tanks have a hard time to enter. So this is the best wall for defense. It's even better than the other wall, the Siegfried Line wall. That should be better, but it isn't because this is more compact. It's harder to actually enter the city, even after removing the gate. You can still fire too. Some of their tanks are inside. Very interesting battle, this one. That tank is driving over my troops as it retreats. And it was taken down by the jeeps. I'm sh- sure it was the jeeps. Alright. Time to send in the rest of your tanks. What are you doing? Yeah, the game would be more functional if the of this wall were removed, I guess. You don't really need walls. At least not walls that are this compact. And if there are to be walls, then they need to be destroyable from the tanks, I guess. That's not possible. You need artillery to take down them. I believe they can be destroyed with artillery, but not the tanks or the planes. They attack with a ram. So making it hard for them to enter. Alright. So our forces have entered here. So, rifleman, you are about to enter the rest of the army under the AI's command. Same with the assault infantry there. Good that they are gathering at center here. Take the center to the last man. Alright, what about the enemy? Can they enter? Or will they be stuck here forever? There is a tank. So at least one threat is inside here. Let's zoom in on the mini map here. Seems to be only one enemy tank inside currently. This building is also vanilla. Hope they will be replaced later, the unique buildings that are still vanilla. Alright. One enemy T-34 tank inside of the large city here, firing at our troops. They can fight through the buildings for some reason. That's something that is to be expected by custom settlements, that they don't really work as walls. Our infantry is firing back, and I'm adding the assault infantry to the army now. There is Manstedt himself in the jeep there, in the green uniform. A new tank has arrived. It's managed to enter the city. There are two enemy tanks inside of the large town now. It's about to probably drive right into our troops there. Others are firing the building. Lost. Enemy general killed. Alexei Ivanov is dead. Their general. Gateway taken. Building lost again. Yeah, the tank arrived. Come on, soldiers of the Reich. Kill those communists. The tank is arriving too, so you might have a problem. Just drew over the other dead tank there. Then we have the second tank firing from this side. I'm playing on huge settings, of course. I mean, this is Total War, so it's more fun to have huge armies. That's the point of Total War. If I wanted smaller groups, then I would play Call of Duty or Commandos or something. Anyway. Thanks to the jeeps, we have managed to kill some of their tanks. Will it be able to drive over our troops here? Or will it be killed before it can do so? The general is in front of the panzer now. Managed to drive over a few of our infantry units there. No! Now it will just have a field day driving over all of these troops. Not that many died here. So these T-34s have medium shells, just like the Panzer IVs. So they aren't the best tanks, but they are still better than the Panzer I's. And it's down! Probably thanks to the jeeps there, with their machine guns. And also we had some SS there that are pretty strong. Infantry can kill tanks too, but usually they can't because they have bad stats. But the SS have been improved, so they are pretty strong. I didn't improve them. Probably Degovex made them better to be comparable to the Italian elite infantry that he also added. Alright. So the troops are moving out here. Here we have some assault infantry. It's possible to destroy these buildings if you have artillery as well. They didn't have any artillery in the besieging army. How annoying that they can't really enter. Most of their tanks. Yeah, my advice to Dagovax is to just remove these walls or make like holes in them, like with the Siegfried Line wall, that you should have areas where they can just move in. Otherwise they get stuck like this, which is annoying, because if I exit the battle, then I will lose. And if I don't, it could go on forever. I could also order my troops to attack, which is exactly what I will do. Attack, soldiers! Kill those tanks! What are you doing? Didn't move to the gate, did you? You have some cars there. Some of them did, however, go where I clicked that they should go. Kill the tanks. What are you doing? Ah, another tank has entered the city. Two tanks have entered the city, so I helped them enter by doing that. Fuck, we lost our general. Manstein died. We also lost the jeeps. AI controls all the airs. Kill that tank. House, I can click on it. So, kill that tank. Erich von Manstein died. Gateway captured again. So, another tank entered. Maybe even two tanks entered. Yeah. This tank is firing towards the SS infantry over here. We have 29 units there. Assault infantry. SS troops. Alright. The other infantry is blocking the way here towards the center. So the other tank will have to kill them all to get there. We still have a lot of tanks outside of the walls. Going T-34. Alright, trying to take a shortcut towards the center. We have infantry here too. So move all the infantry and assault riflemen back to that unit. So they will take them over. If the T-34 will win this. It's going to drive them over. The fucker. Alright. Our infantry is in trouble. We are still numerical enough to... We are still numerous enough to be able to win, I guess, against one tank here. It's driving everyone over. Trying to reach the plaza, which it probably will be able to reach now. Almost all the infantry broke. Right. All of these did break. Their numbers didn't help. The infantry aren't worth much in this game. They are good for keeping order in a settlement, but they are not that good at defending a settlement. It's up to the field armies to defend. If they are beaten, then the cities are kind of fucked. If the attacker has anything better than infantry himself. Right. Soldiers, into the unit. Let the AI use you to defend the city. I'm too lazy to do it. Anyway. We'll see. Running guy there. Alien cars, yeah. Drive over the SS, yeah. While simultaneously firing at something. Firing at these guys, maybe. Assault infantry. Into the unit they're defending. Here is the Soviet tank. This settlement is very detailed when it comes to all the extra stuff, such as civilian cars and such. I believe we had lamps too in a prior version, but had to remove them because of a hardcore limit in number of unique buildings you can have in the city. Because he wants more custom settlements for other factions, and then we can't have too many custom buildings for German cities on. So we seem to have defeated the tanks. I can't find them. Attack the tanks. Let's fast forward. This took a lot of time. We have some infantry unit here. The rest to enter. Let's remove that. So we will do this. We will move everyone out. Now we will probably lose by doing this. We have no choice if we want this battle to be over. We will retake the settlement later. Where are you going? I told you to exit the city, not to spread out in the city. You are in control of the gate, but they still refuse to move. Yeah, we had quite the numbers. Look at the modern buildings of the large town. Looks kinda cool when they move in this settlement. Anyway, move out of the city. What the fuck? I didn't understand how to exit the city. One unit may be able to. Yeah, one unit can exit, but not the entire army. Maybe we need more of them to exit. Wonder if their tanks will catch up on our activity. The city is being emptied here. Most of the army had already exited. Exit the city and fight on the battlefield outside instead. I like how legions move in Rome Total War. It's the same in other mods for Rome Total War, that they move like a big snake. I like that. In Medieval 2 they don't move in such a tight formation. Alright. So we need you to move out. Station yourselves. The riflemen are on their knees here, prepared for new orders. Some units are still moving there. Some there as well already. Alright. Tanks. And run when you do it. AI control, and of course we don't want fast forward in the battle, that's not good. So the tanks are moving against the infantry here, driving over our poor troops there. Had quite a few tanks left. Most of our infantry are already broken. Even the units with 75, and the units and not all too, but soon. We have entered the city. Soldiers return to the city, to the center of the city. Alright, they got slaughtered as expected. I didn't expect the infantry to win on the field. Just wanted the battle over with. Even one tank can handle a lot of infantry. Trying to return the city this way is not that smart. They have the ram there blocking their gate. The guy here managed to do it. He died, he was shot dead. Yeah. And we lost. All our troops are broken, that's why we lost. But we would have lost in 1 minute 10 seconds anyway. Alright, Erich von Manstein died, he had 751 men, and he killed 125 men remaining, 226, but they will all die when they take the city. And Alexei Ivanov had 361 men, mostly tanks too, we had mostly infantry, and he killed 511 of our 751, and have about the same left. 20 more, alright. And the detailed statistics. The battle is over. They took the large town. Never in history has the navy landed an army at the planned time and place, but if you hand us anywhere within 50 miles of Fidela within 1 week of D-Day, I'll go ahead and win. Major General George Patton, November 1942, commenting on the North African landings. didn't crash after battle. Good. So the British fleet is now blockading the port of Copenhagen. Candidate for adoption, benefactor Erwin Rommel. So in Berlin we have a new general. Let's move him to Hamburg. Hamburg has a new governor. We have a British fleet moved closer to Amsterdam, but it's not locating any port currently. We have another fleet here. The worst fleet of the British. Or I think so. No, it's the second worst. They have some good ships here too, the Hood for example. But mostly Black Swan ships. So our second fleet is now moving up here. We are going to face the British here. We have some Hoods, some Black Swan ships, but no Prince of Wales. Alright. Clearly have the upper hand in this battle. Maybe we won't attack this time. We will wait on the other fleet to reach them. They have lost some ships in their fight against the Soviet Union. Only these remain after I just merged the fleet. The ships that were remaining of the fleet. Faction announcements. So we have some heroic deaths there. Erich von Manstein died. A new family member. Mila Sabine, probably a female. Yeah. And then we have a new largest faction, the United Soviet Socialist Republic, so the USSR, also known as the Soviet Union, they are now the largest faction. And they aren't entirely beaten. We have a few ships left from the fleet that we defeated. I see. So when we moved our ships, they returned with the few ships they had left. We have more ships remaining though. Stalino. Settlement occupied. Yeah. So they took back Stalino. Our Italian allies are still holding this area, Kharkov. With half an army. Then we have Hungary, our other ally there. Settlement occupied, Stalino. End of turn report. We are minus 14,092, so it looks slightly better than last time. Agent detected Bulgaria. An enemy agent has been discovered and executed. How sad that that German virtues of trust and loyalty have been cynically exploited by our foes. Yeah. But they are not our foes, they are our ally. So they were spying on us. Another force is down there. A larger force. Let's just move the army there. Have no problem with that. The general will move there, of course. Will be another great battle. They have combined some forces there. With still starting armies. Combine a few of those starting armies, I see. Have mostly infantry in Kyiv. This army could try to attack, but I think we will skip Stalino for now. We will move back. We don't want to lose the army just yet. Stalino is lost for now, they have too many armies there. Alright, and for this army we could move the SS troops to Brest. And the infantry. And Then we move this army towards the front. The Vesp artillery, mobile artillery now joining. So we have a fully mechanized force here. Not to be underestimated. Sniper unit was needed there, otherwise it's fully mechanized. Alright. This army could move to Athens this time. Alright. So we entered Athens with almost the full army. Unfortunately, half the army is infantry. They will still scare away the Bulgarians or Italians from attacking there. We need 4 units in Benghazi. But I will start besieging Tobruk here, held by the Free French. And maintain the siege there for now. We need a ram at least. I will move this force closer to the American front. We are currently in Vichy-held territory, an ally. I hope they won't attack us while we are moving in their lands. The Vichy have a fleet close to our area of Tunis, only 1 unit of ships, so the large fleet isn't there. Fortunately, Admiral Guido, with a great Italian fleet, including Sacchi trooper ships, but also some really good ships. The Julius Caesare, their second best battleship, are there. Alright. We have our U-boat fleet that could be moved. Try to sink the American ships there, but we couldn't reach them this time. So we have U-boats here. Right. Time to look at the construction again. Nothing to do in Berlin. München, nothing to do currently. So in Frankfurt we had some farms that we could still build. Frankfurt. So, and we're done in Frankfurt. In Amsterdam we could also build some farms. Right. And we're down there. Bristol seems to also have farms there for us to build. Building seems to be customized, maybe not the port, but I don't care. I think we will have to build a port from scratch, because Germany didn't have much of a fleet anyway. Of course they had some ports, but I will build it like in the ordinary game. I won't use any fast build cheat to build it. Alright, I need to take a pause. I need to go to the toilet, but see you soon. Yeah. So I'm back. Alright. I need to go take a pee anyway. So we are in Paris currently and we need to build that farm. Alright. Farms should be built everywhere. Vanilla remnant. Alright, we don't have a lot of money left now. Take some time, a while before we can actually start building new buildings and actual units could be recruited. Smolensk, yeah. So we're done there. built a lot of farms there. Farms plus one, farms plus two, farms. Alright. And what can we do now? We could fight the battle here. That's what we are going to do. We need to limit the number of their armies. Soviet armies are too many. We need to limit them. We are going to stand a chance here against the Soviet advance. And I saw a very strong light flash. I put my arms over my face unconsciously. The whole city was destroyed and burning. There was no place to go. Michiko Yamaoka, survival of the atomic bombing of Hiroshima, August 6, 1945. Yeah, the atomic bomb was no joke. Fortunately, there are no atomic bombs in this game. So the United States will have to invade Japan by sea in order to win in this game. More fair too. But a lot of more lives will be will be spent doing that. Yeah. Anyway, start the battle. Turn to the other army with riflemen there. So the enemy has lots of infantry and tanks. Do they have anything that isn't just starting armies? No, they have only T-34s. They combined, I believe three starting armies. So they have 3 units of infantry and 15 units of T-34 tanks. It's a strong force, and we have planes, of course, Messerschmitt 109s and Stuka bombers, and we have some infantry and BMW motorcycles as usual, and Panzer 1s, Panzer 4s, etc. I don't believe we have anything better. Maybe a bodyguard is a Tiger tank too. Or it's just 2 jeeps. One of them is a jeep general. Maybe both of them, if we're unlucky here. Yeah, we have 2 jeep generals. I'm not sure. They already started to fire. The fighter planes are already firing at their troops here. They have a very long range. Well, their troops are still regrouping, but now their tanks are moving. Those projectiles of the Messerschmitt 109s are not bad. They have very long range, so it's very easy to hit their troops even when they are this far away. Alright. I think the smartest thing the Soviets could do is just charge my army, but they seem to be bent on regrouping and moving them back instead. Not the smartest move. Here we have some farmland. Haven't seen that before. A lot of farmland. And a building here. We can't reach it. Wonder if that is vanilla. Probably. Not necessarily. So the Russian areas do have planes. That's very true to the Ukraine areas, etc. That's cool. So their generals are already dead. They may have 3 generals in this battle. One of them is dead. Reinforcement, Gunter von Klug. But our 2 generals are in the same army. So. And our army is now charging finally. Yeah, we have two units of jeeps. As bodyguard, that's for sure. Very much to this marching forward from the battlefield. Well, the Soviet Union has moved back to their farms here and are still retreating or regrouping or whatever. You can see why they retreat the infantry, but where did the tanks go? They actually retreated with the tanks, even though they have 15 tanks. That was coming. Fortunately, their infantry might not be able to run away. It's so slow when it moves that our mechanized stuff might be able to catch them before they run away. So you moved back all your troops from the battle, including 15 units of tanks. Let's fast forward. I don't have time to wait. Let them escape. Why not charge? Heroic victory, yeah, but no one died, or almost no one. We killed 345, probably only their infantry too. Did the game just crash? Fuck, if that's the case. Then I just need to replay it. That sucks. Yeah, I believe it's gamelock.